welcome to this episode of Vartalap. Good to see you. How are you doing?
Hello, I'm fine. Working from home, lot of work, and yes, I'm hoping that lockdown will get over. Situation will be improved by then.
Okay. So for my listeners, Alka has more than 20 plus years of experience in journalism. She's currently associated with Mumbai Mirror as an assistant editor, and she has won several awards as well. And I'll be happy if you want to add anything to your profile, Alka.
Yes. No, that's it. I'm in Mumbai for last 16 years. Yes, before that I was working with Marathi newspaper called Sakal in Pune and Konkan. Okay. That includes,
okay.
More or less 20 years.
Right. So you have had a long journalistic history, Alka. You've done a lot of stories. You've won awards for some of them as well. Which is one story that you would like to discuss that was closest to your heart or gave you a lot of satisfaction?
Yes, I wouldn't call it, it was my happiest story. I would say that gave me satisfaction of doing my duty. Mm-hmm. And that is after rationalist Dr. Narendra Dabholkar was killed, mm-hmm. The investigation was really on slow track. We did not one, but many stories on this one subject. When I joined Mumbai Mirror, earlier I was working with IBN Lokmat Marathi News Channel and Nikhil Wagle was my editor there. So, of course, after Dr. Dabholkar got killed, we did many stories in IBN Lokmat also. Yeah. But when the investigation was handed over to CBI and CBI was not ready to take over the investigation with speed, in Mumbai Mirror, we did many stories on the slow pace of investigation, say why the government was not ready to hand over the manpower from the office and everything. And this one particular story, where I interviewed one of the witnesses who said that after Dabholkar got killed, the same day and next day, he alerted almost 7 agencies and police officers and told them that, he thinks that Virendra Singh Tavade, now main accused arrested in this case, who was arrested very late after Kalburgi was killed, after Pansare got killed, that time Tavade got arrested. So he said that I informed and alerted 7 agencies saying that I have my suspicion over this man for this particular reason and police did nothing. Okay, that time NCP Congress government was in power. So when we see that, you know, right wing, left wing, Congress is secular, BJP is right wing, all these binaries on ground, they all are same. And they really don't care about our rationalists, our thinkers. And if Congress NCP government thought the importance of this information, this tip off, they could have stopped next murders.
Right.
We would have not lost Dr. Govind, like Advocate Govind Pansare. We would have not lost Professor M.M. Kalburgi. We would have saved our dear Gauri Lankesh. So this is the story. Now we cannot go back and reverse what happened with them. But as a journalist, it is my duty to follow up the investigation. It is my duty to expose the police and political system that they claim we are secular. We are following Phule, Shahu, Ambedkar. But in reality, they are the same.
Okay. So you have done a lot of stories in rural hinterland as well, Alka.
Yes.
And how do you see democracy has percolated in the country in last 70 years? So if you compare Gram Sabhas and Gram Panchayats with the municipal bodies in urban centers or Vidhan Parishads and Vidhan Sabhas, how is that percolation of democracy in rural hinterland in India?
So answering your first question, I would take help of great poet Namdev Dhasal, who said, Swatantra kutlya gadhvinicha naav ahe. So the point is, when we say we got freedom and democracy and everything, mm-hmm. hinterland is still struggling. I'm not saying that everything is negative. 74th amendment of the constitutional amendment has, and 73rd has brought real decentralization of democracy on the grassroots, say it in urban area or in rural area. But the problem is, initially when women were not allowed to participate in democratic process, even in today's time, if you go and cover Gram Panchayat, Gram Sabhas, we hardly cover BMC standing committee election, standing committee meeting. We cover BMC meetings, but we don't go in hinterland to watch what happens at the Gram Sabha level, okay, or at Panchayat Samiti Sabha level, or at Jilla Parishad level. We don't bother to cover daily happenings, routine at these levels. So if you go and see, it is all, I mean, the business is done by men mostly. You will hardly see 10%, I don't know, 10% could be also extra. You will hardly see female participation in all this democratic process. So my question is, if you're not involving 50% of your population in your daily business, and you are running the, and you are making the policies, you are taking the decisions, and you are running the government and governance, then how would you call it democratic? That is my first question. So this gender discrimination is affecting our democracy. We need to leave, we need to give up on our patriarchal mindset. We need to give up on these patriarchal businesses and style of running the governance. Agar dekhenge, even in Mantralay, even in all the cabinet meetings, you will see hardly there is female representation. I mean, if you could see any female participant, it is just for the sake of representation. My point is with represent, for the we are not made for representation purposes. We female are half part of this world, and in India and in rural area, you need to take it into account. Unfortunately, that is not happening. Second thing I would say that many many rural development schemes have changed the face of villages, but the caste and class system is still intact. And so when we cover of you know, Bahujan, Vanchit stories of their communities, I mean those who are coming from nomadic tribe, those who are backward class people, those who are Dalit, they are still facing many problems which are not reflected and reported in mainstream papers. The other day, I was interviewing Sunita Bhosle, who represents Pardhi community, and she was telling me the same day in Bid, three people from Pardhi community were murdered because of the land dispute. No paper, no mainstream paper had covered that event. So the thing is, when we say democracy, 74th Amendment, abhi mahilaon ka sahabha kiya hai, but ye बहुत सारी चीजें still ornamental है. So I am really not happy about the way we are carrying our development. But yes, I am really grateful to Dr. Babasaheb Ambedkar, who thought of women power, who thought of rural India, who thought of that hinterland, and he gave all the powers to these people. तो हम लोगों को लगता है कि मंत्री चला रहा है सरकार, बट आप अगर देखेंगे तो वो लोगों के रिप्रेजेंटेटिव्स है. We have to write stories, we have to remind people that it is you who are running the government and you should awake, and this power is your power. So वो नहीं हो रहा है
unfortunately. What do you think of something like a women's reservation bill which has been pending for several years? Would that also not be just ornamental, as you said? I mean, there might be women who might come into assemblies and Lok Sabha and Vidhan Parishad and Vidhan Sabhas, but their men might still be driving them behind the scenes. So that
I understand where your argument is coming from, but I would 100% disagree with this typical argument, which comes with no study. When the women representation was made compulsory in rural area, or I would say in local self-local government, 74th Amendment. So क्या हुआ? Everyone started making same argument कि नहीं नहीं ये तो puppet women representatives रहेंगे और इनको कुछ दिमाग ही नहीं है तो नहीं. This is again coming from a patriarchal mindset that महिलाओं को कहाँ कुछ समझता है तो reservation देके भी कुछ क्या फायदा होगा क्या होगा. तो my point is that if women are not given any access. In current situation, women are not given, they are outrightly denied of their rights. If you give reservation, they will get a chance. On party level, decision making mein ek mahila wing banai jati hai, baki mahilaon ko kuch sthan nahi rehta. Aap dekhiye, Congress ki meeting, NCP ki meeting, Manasik ki meeting, ये शिवसेना की मीटिंग, भाजपा की मीटिंग, महिलाओं की एक विंग बना के उसमें महिलाओं को स्थान दिया जाता है, पार्टी का जो रेगुलर बिजनेस है उसमें स्थान नहीं रहता है। तो हुआ ये कि ये महिलाएं कार्यकर्ता बन के काम करती है, वेयर विल दे गेट रिप्रेजेंटेशन? सो व्हेन दे गेट रिप्रेजेंटेशन इन लोकल सेल्फ गवर्नमेंट, व्हेन द कंपल्शन रिजर्वेशन केम, इट हेल्प रियली। सो यू विल सी सम ऑफ देम आर रिलेटिव्स ऑफ द करंट पॉलिटिशियंस, सम ऑफ देम आर ओके देयर हस्बैंड्स ट्राई टू ड्राइव द सीट, बट लेट मी टेल यू दैट ऑल वीमेन आर नॉट ब्रेनलेस, ऑल वीमेन आर नॉट फुलिश। So when you make such idiotic argument, I am so sorry. This comes with the basic vision ki mahilaon ko puppet karke easily use ho sakta hai aur mahilaon ko kuch dimag nahi rehta. Rabdi Devi ka udaharan hamesha is ek argument ke liye diya jata hai. But aap Rabdi Devi se bahar aaye hai kya aap log kabhi? Go and meet Mr. Bhim Raskar, who has done a fabulous work empowering all these women who are running in Gram Panchayat government, who are a successful politicians or on rural India. They are coming from really no background, zero background, rural area. Unke ghar mein koi padhai tak nahi ki hai. And today they can tell you that kaun si yojana ka paisa kaha ja raha hai, what is useful, what is not useful, how we should do, conduct meetings, who are stakeholders, what are the loopholes, how we should plan financially. They can tell you. All these women, we can see their faces because of this reservation bill. So please stop telling us that, you know, humne kya karna chahiye, ye jab tak mard batate rahenge, wohi mera problem hai. This is my problem, that you don't get to tell me that women have brains or they don't have brains. We need access, we need opportunity. And I guess if that opportunity is given to rural India women who are in politics, we can see the change.
So that was not my perspective. That was just a question.
I know.
So one thing again on something like this, when we talk about women empowerment, why not start with allocating them 50% of the seats when the elections are being fought? Wouldn't that bring in more level field even before going into reservation and directly into assemblies? If every party gives 50% of the ticket to the women for fighting elections, wouldn't that make a difference as well?
Yes, I don't know about 50% reservation, because this is very what should you say? This will never come. This will never happen. I mean, we can demand, they should give it, but people who are not ready to give even representation to women in their daily meetings, I don't think so. They will give away power so easily, and that's why the reservation bill should come in effect. I am in full support of that bill. Once you give access, things will change on ground.
Okay. So you talked about caste and class, and affirmative action has started in India. I mean, there have been a lot of things which have happened post-independence, and affirmative action, like in terms of caste-based reservations in education as well as jobs, have been in force since 1990s. We are sitting in 2020. How do you see India developing as a caste agnostic nation? Are we on the path towards resolving those caste biases both in urban as well as rural centers, or are we still very far away from that?
No, I have done a long reportage on this subject, that caste atrocities are increasing day by day. Mm-hmm. Not only in rural area, even in urban areas, those are we tend to ignore all these atrocities, discrimination and exploitation based on caste, but they are there. They are very much there, and that's why we need to keep writing about it. If you're talking about criminal issue or section in the reservation, that is up to the experts and academician to talk about. But if you ask me, reservation has done a great service to the backward class people, to Dalit, to nomadic tribes, and we can see the real talent. They got opportunities because of this reservation, and that is why, yes, whatever updates we need to do in the policy, it is up to the Supreme Court and the expert committees to take a decision. But if you ask me, I am full supporter of reservation, and it is indeed has done great service to these people for years, for 100 years. We have done injustice to generations. And if you read Enrich Dalit literature, which is available in Marathi, now translated in English, you will come to know J.R. Pinto has translated some of the great literature. You will come to know that what they have suffered. So you cannot just ask with all, I mean, when you, I say you, it is not you, you know, people who say that thing. So when you say ki aaj reservation hata do aur chalo competition karte, but what are the privileges you are enjoying for years? Are you ready to give up all these privileges? Are you ready to give up the residential property, the land, car, bike, bank mein jo paisa hai, saving hai, wo sab aap रखो एक जगह पे, आप बोलो कि मुझे ये कुछ नहीं चाहिए, एंड देन इफ यू आर रेडी टू कॉम्पीट विद द पर्सन हुज फादर इज क्लीनिंग योर ड्रेनेज और हुज फादर इज क्लीनिंग योर टॉयलेट और हुज मदर इज क्लीनिंग द रोड्स आउटसाइड, इफ यू आर रेडी टू कॉम्पीट विद चिल्ड्रन ऑफ दिस वर्कर्स, देन टेल अस, यू विल वॉक अराउंड इन कार्स, यू विल live in posh houses, you will have bank balance, and you will say, chalo, let's compete, reservation nikal do. This is all bullshit and coming with mere ignorance. I mean, you people who make this argument ki reservation nikalo, I think they need to get aware about their privileges. Mm-hmm. But caste system and the problems because of the existing caste systems are very much there.
Okay, so moving away from this, we are living in COVID times, so it has affected yes. everybody globally. And as a journalist, you are under the exempted services. How has your work changed, or it has impacted you working in your day-to-day business?
Yeah, it has impacted greatly on my business. I work in print media, which is Mumbai Mirror newspaper. Yeah. I don't remember when I last saw the fresh newspapers outside my door, you know. Okay. I miss those days, and it has become a dream ki ek din wapas I can hold hard copy of the newspaper in hand. My colleagues are getting it, but mm-hmm. I'm still struggling to get one the copy. Yes, it has impacted immensely on journalists. Basically, I am working from home because my company has asked me to do so, and I have successfully produced a few good articles, I would say, because there are problems. I have been in Mumbai for last 16 years, so I have contacts. So I have just changed the way I operate in normal time and in lockdown. I do video calls a lot. I spoke to many people. I make many calls just to verify the little piece of information which I have, mm-hmm. because I think it is my responsibility to deliver correct and fair information. With all sides, without not blaming or painting anybody in black, say it is hospital management, government, or anybody,
okay,
contractors. So I tried to do that. Having said this, I would say that situation is really grim. We have seen what laborers or daily wages are going through. So we have been reporting about the plight of daily wages since the lockdown has started. I have also reported about essential goods. You know, they were out of shelf, and what are the problems distributors are facing, what are the problems producers are facing. I've been reporting on APMC, which is Agriculture Producers Market Committee, APMC committee, APMC in Navi Mumbai, which is called Mumbai APMC, has more than 300 positive cases till now, and it has affected mainly farmers, because farmers could not send their agri goods to this market. So I've been reporting about that. I've also reported a few stories, more than 5 stories, on dead body management during pandemic, which is really a concern of everybody now. Furnaces are non-functional. Then earlier dead body bags were not available. Mm-hmm. Before that, there was a confusion over suspected dead bodies. I mean, should they cover up in dead body bag? Should they give dead suspected death certificate, provisional death certificate or not? Mm-hmm. And all these questions, confusions impacted this pandemic in great ways. Mm-hmm. So I've been reporting about that. I have reported about what was the condition in Cooper Hospital, mm-hmm. when a patient was surrounded by dead bodies in the ward, okay, uncovered dead bodies. Then we saw what happened at Sion Hospital, how patients are waiting to get bed for 17 hours, 18 hours, for 3 days patients wait to get bed. Then there are cases of bad quality inside the quarantine facility. So I've been reporting about that. I have been talking to patients, relatives. And very recently, if you see, ICMR had changed the protocol. And so asymptomatic COVID patients have been discharged from the isolation facility.
Okay.
So I've been reporting their concerns because they stay in really small, tiny houses. It's maybe 6x7, 10x10. So usme aap asymptomatic COVID patient ko bol rahe, you go home and they are going to stay back with their parents or in-laws who are already elderly people. They are living with comorbidity. So you are increasing risk.
Mm-hmm. So one last question, Alka. You have reported a lot around COVID, the impact as well as the other assessments that you have made. How do you see the handling of central as well as the state government? Maharashtra is number one affected state. How do you see the overall handling of both the central and state government?
I would say that we are experimenting every day, which is really unfortunate. I have not seen this much chaos and mess in any other country as of now. Of course, we can criticize USA anytime, but still, we could have done much better. With the help of epidemiologists, with the help of public health expert, with the help of social organization, NGOs, like laborers ka issue, abhi tak government ne NGOs ko saath mein nahi liya. Civic effort jo shuru hai, wo uski wajah se bahut sare government ke problem cover up ho gaye hai. Then IMA, the Modern Medicine Doctors Organization, was taken into confidence very late. Okay, in third phase of the lockdown, had the government conducted a meeting with them in the before or in the first phase of the lockdown, it would have helped all patients. Like making allegations against doctors will not help us ki wo nahi hospital shuru rakh rahe hai, ye problem hai, wo problem hai. But my thing is, what are we doing for them? Are we reporting what is happening with them? No. So government was experimenting every day. Central level to utter chaos and utter mismanagement. I mean, the way Prime Minister Narendra Modi came on television and announced that, okay, we are going to do this. First thali bajao, then whatever. Event bhaji. You could have given time. You could have done better management for all these laborers. Delhi, we did not think of them. So that is the problem. And I guess we will have very tough time. Because monsoon is arriving in a few days and we are not seeing flattening the curve yet. So we all have to prepare very tough time ahead. And I'll say that we have to be very careful. We cannot say ki police ne ye nahi kiya, yahan wo nahi. Abhi aapko bed nahi milne wala easily. Aapke paas kitna bhi paisa ho. Abhi aapko quarantine facility mein achi AC wali suvidha nahi milne wali hai. Na abhi aap daily wages hai to aapko khana milega, ye bhi koi guarantee nahi hai. तो हमारे खुद के भरोसे आत्मनिर्भर छोड़ दिया है हमें सरकार ने, दोनों सरकार ने.
I'll be positive on that side. I think the governments have tried their best. There are loopholes in terms of how they could have done something, things better. But there are certain things which the state could have done better. Or there are certain things in terms of policy which the center could have probably thought of much better. But yeah, I mean, there are, as you rightly said, there would be a tough time ahead. Keeping in mind that the lockdown opens up, there would be people out in the streets as well. And in a country, India, which is not very resource heavy in terms of healthcare, there would be issues in terms of people finding space in hospitals, getting tested and so on and so forth. So,
no, I would like to interrupt. I mean, it is not resource. I mean, it is not some natural problem we in India we have. If we are not spending budget on medical education, if we are not investing in medical education, how are we going to produce a specialist doctors in overnight? I mean, that is the point. You could have done better management on central level. You did not address issues faced by farmers. You did not address, I mean, both government. They did not address issues faced by doctors, health workers, nurses. Transportation of these workers were not taken care of. So on each level, जो पहले ही package announce किया है, उसको ही एक नया color देके अब आत्मनिर्भर package बना के अगर बेचना चाहते हो, तो we will not buy that. Okay? You had earlier announced Make in India. So you don't come and tell us that आत्मनिर्भर बनो. What are you really giving? I mean, if you go through FICCI and every organization union has issued a press release, if you read it, you will understand that here I'm not taking a stand against Narendra Modi government just because I like to criticize the government. We are seeing what is happening on the ground every day. I mean, you go and talk to grape exporters and you will realize that they're screwed for the next few years. If you talk to mango exporters, they will tell you their story. If you talk to tomato producers, they will tell you their story. If you try and talk to doctors, they will tell their stories. So on each level, governments have failed drastically. They could have done much, much better had we rise up beyond above politics.
Okay. I mean, I'll take the point. I am not in the midst of thick of the story, so I cannot comment on some of it. What I read through or what I understand from the various things that come in newspaper and in media, I'll say let's agree to disagree on certain things, which is fine. But it's been a pleasure to hear your perspective, Alka. I mean,
thank you very much.
You have done a lot of research on some of these stories, so it was really valuable, and I'm sure our listeners will love some of it as well. In case I have any queries, I'll be happy to pass on to them.
Sure. Thank you very much. Thank you
Thanks,
very
Alka.
Much.
Have a good afternoon.
Bye.
Bye.
Yes. Bye.